that was perfect timing. We got a storm on the way. And the forklift doesn't have a very good canopy on it. So normally what I do is I'll use the forklift to it's hard to get the cherry picker under this around this dunnage. So I'll just use the forklift and scoop it up and I can get the cherry picker underneath it. However, I don't want to get wet, so I've just brought, instead of being over there with all that stuff, I brought the engine around to my empty lift here, and then I could just use the lift arm. I'll take that lift arm, I'll bring it up and over the top of the motor, wrap the chain around it, pick it up to get the dunnage tray out of the way. And then what I'm doing over here is I'm stripping this engine. I'm just taking everything off of it that's got to go onto the new engine. And I'm laying it on top. I'm using this, the dunnage tray, the dunnage top as a workbench. I'm just putting everything where it goes. So we got our left and right manifolds, left and right motor mounts, front accessories on this side. You know, the cam sensor going on that side. Our flywheel bolts, flywheel starter shim, wiring harness. And the only thing I got left to take off is that, but I don't even need to take that off because it comes with a new one. And a new one comes with all the hardware. So I'll probably just leave it on there, but I'd like to drain it. The rebuilders, I want to get them back full of antifreeze. Plus, I need this sensor here. So, check back in a little bit. Alright, so this engine is stripped and drained, and the only thing left to get off of it is the lifting bracket and the knock sensor. So I'm just going to roll this thing out of the way, and we'll get that off of there, and then I got to clean up all these parts and transfer them to the new engine, and we'll take a look at putting them back in the vehicle.